Right, it's time to paint the Easter Bunny. Now I'm going to try this one a little bit different. I'm going to use some vibrant colours in it instead of the brown fur or white fur. We'll see what happens. We'll see how it comes out. Now, where do I start? I think I'll start on that way, if I make a mistake, it's not so bad. I can fix it. I'm going to use a large flat brush. Still a bit damp from the last painting. Now I'm going to go with a base colour of yellow. I'm going to add some water to that yellow just to help it spread. Now it's going to have a black outline around the outside, so I'm not too fussy about the edges. In fact, I'm going to put yellow on the entire bunny. Just a watered down yellow. It's just a base colour. It helps to put a base colour down because then when you paint over the top of it, it adheres a lot better. The canvas, when it's only just been primed, likes to grab onto the paint and it's hard to paint. So I always put a base coat down. First coat, whatever you want to call it. Notice I'm adding water to the paint. This allows the paint to flow a lot easier. It also allows the paint to sink into the pores of the canvas to get all those little white spots that you leave. Right, there's the base. Okay, I'll do his paws later. What do I do down there? Now, so yellow is going to be the lighter colour. I'm going to use orange for the darker sections. Then the darkest part, I'm going to use this magenta. And it's just a matter of I'm going to be doing some blending. So that's the color I'm really going for the bunny. I'll leave the inside of his ears yellowy colour. Then I just want to pinch, and I'm going to add it to so I've added magenta to the orange, and I'm going to go a smaller brush for this. Going to use a flat medium size brush. Add some water to it. As you can see, it's a lot of blending in this one. Blending those colours together so you can't see any straight lines, any brush strokes. It just fades from one shade to another. And again, you can spend hours doing that to get a perfect. Don't. That's my advice. Having some character in your brush strokes is always good. Down here I'm going to add some white on the inside of his ears. Do the same on the other side. His ears are starting to get a bit of shape now. I just add a little bit more darker magenta to the darker spots of these ears. Just might leave a little few strokes in there just to indicate the fur. Just going to do that outside edge of his ears. This one in particular with some yellow. It's going to have a blue background and I want that yellow to contrast the blue. The other ear, let's go with that purple, magenta. Couple of the flat edge of the brush, just to, some strokes, just to give it a bit of hair impression. Right. Just wanted to find that back edge of his ear. Try and add a bit of purple to it this time, just to get it a little bit darker. That's it. Yep, I'm using my finger. Okay, so we're going from the lights to the dark colours. Always work from the lights and then into the darks, because you can't really go over dark colours with light colours. Just doing some smudging with my fingers. Yeah, let's do his face. that yellow down again, just as a base to work my orange. A white crown. Darker between the eyes. Just trying to give it a bit of shape. Paint the eyes in over all this. Darker under the eyes. And this, I notice I'm using strokes where I'm not blending so much this time. I'm just letting that straight paint stay in there. Yep, on the canvas. It gives that furry feel. Right, up to his cheeks. Where did I put his cheeks? There. It's going to start off a bit darker. Get some orange in that middle bit there. Then I'm going to bring it into white. Scratching it with the back of the brush just to get some shape into it. Not shape, some lines. You don't want to overdo this though. The bottom part's a bit darker because of the it's in a shaded area. Giving you more magenta than the purple, because the magenta is much nicer color to look at. The purple's more just for shading. I'm just using that magenta to put those whiskers out on his cheeks. Accidentally dipped in white. Back to the orange. Orange is my base color, so I've got to keep that orange going through the whole theme. You see how the yellow comes through from the background. Works well. Right, now I'll do his paws. So I'm going to paint them yellow. It's the base color we used. It's got a bit of orange in it, but it doesn't matter because I've gone with orange as the main color in the picture. Four strokes down, just to give you an idea of where to go with the paws. Scratching some rough surface, even though I'll kind of paint over a lot of it. Just breaks up the blobs. Now, go over the main parts of white, the highlighted parts, sorry, the high points. Needs a bit more orange in that, this paw. Right, now I'm going to do the flowers, sorry, the leaves. I mix purple and white. Once again, these leaves are going to be outlined. So the edges don't have to be perfect. We'll do every second one purple. Try a little blue in that. Blend it. Green, light green, yellow, light green or yellow with dark green. White. So we use dark green, yellow and white to make a lighter green. Need to add some water to it. Like I said many times, the water allows the paint to flow better, as you can see with my brushing now. And it fills up all the pores in the canvas. Let's get some dark green. Still too much dark green on my brush, so I'm not going to blend until I wipe my brush. Otherwise it would have been too overpowering. Like I just did then. Going to lighten it up a bit too, a bit of white. Generally, with any picture, you have three versions of a colour. You have the lighter version, mid version, and dark version. Same as what I'm doing with these leaves. And same on the other side. Right. Now I'm going to do my starry flowers, which will be teal. I got paint on me. These are just like mini stars. The black lines around them are the way that'll shape them. Put a white dot, flick it out. Back of my brush, flick it out. I'm ready for the eyes and the nose and the mouth. Black. I'll just be back. I'll be got to get some back. Back in black. So I'm just going to paint the eyes black to start with. Put the little creases in the corners of the eyes. And now the nose. I'm thinking magenta probably for the nose. It's going to be shiny in the front. Try not to blend too much because you just turn the white into pink. I'm going to highlight the top edge with a white line. Just a bit of the bottom. The reflection in the eye. Black under the nose and nostrils. Blend that a little bit. Tied it up with a bit of orange. Now, out the background. Going a smaller round brush for that. So now that I've painted this, these blue stars are going to have to go. Bad choice of color.
If you found this video entertaining, helpful or inspiring, we'd love for you to consider subscribing to our channel and hitting that notification bell. Subscribing will ensure that you never miss out on any of our future content that we create especially for you.